In this video, we will move on to the interior of the scene and create day and night shots. In the process, we will import Thea models into the scene, modify their materials, add lights, use the Relight editor and control the camera. Let's start by adjusting the sun's position to get more sunlight into our scene. The scene is still too dark, and increasing the brightness of the scene means changing one of these three values. In this case, we will decrease the shutter value. The false color LUT can help us to identify areas that are over or underexposed. First, let's bring up the shadows by lowering the shadows value. To compensate for the overexposed areas, we will lower the highlights value to the point where we do not have any red areas. Let's create a material for the floor. Create a new SketchUp material, load the diffuse texture and apply it to the floor. Select the material for editing in the Thea material editor by clicking on the floor with the Thea cursor. Switch to the bitmap-based preset for easier assigning of the textures. Click on its channel and load the corresponding textures. Let's see how we can convert 3D files to Thea models and import them into the scene. To do this, we will add a custom folder that contains the files we wish to convert. Right-click on Custom Folder and select Add Folder. Click on Select Folder to add it to the list. If we now click on the new entry, we will see all the supported 3D models. To convert them to Thea models, all that's needed is to double-click on them. A Thea model will be created in the same folder and ready to be placed in the scene. We can now modify its materials using proxy editing. The next step is to use Content Browser to add models into the scene. This is how the scene looks so far. Let's go on and create a night shot of the scene. For this one, we will need to add ceiling lights. First, switch to the Lights tab and click on the Spotlight icon. To place a light into the scene, we first need to click once to define the position of the light and another one for the target. Let's also make a few copies of it. Why not turning off the Thea physical sky and start interactive rendering to see how the lights affect the scene? As you can see, while its spotlight is around 100 watts, the image is still dark. Thea should be treated like a real camera, and just like it happens in the real world, instead of increasing the light's intensity, we need to adjust the exposure of the camera. Switch to the Display tab and adjust the ISO, shutter and f-number values to typical values for a night shot. After that, we can slightly change the power of the lights until we're satisfied with the overall illumination. One thing that we would also like to add here is a color for the environment to give us the blue color of the night sky. We will go to the Environment tab and use an HDR image in the Illumination channel. The intensity of the Illumination channel needs to be adjusted, so let's decrease its value. We are now ready to render the final image. The next part is to use the Relight editor. Before we start working with Relight, we'll use this simple scene to understand how lights are grouped in the Relight editor. In the first case, we have one Thea light that has been copied 2 times. This means that all 3 lights are instances of the same Thea light. When we render the scene with Relight enabled, we notice that there is only one light in the editor. We can remove a light from the group by using the Make Unique command. This results in having two different Relight groups. If we want each light to have its own Relight group, we need to create each one from scratch. The last case is using mesh lights. Here we have four unique surfaces. We will apply two emitting materials to them. Mesh lights are grouped based on their emitting material, and in this case we have two of them. Now that we have a better understanding of how lights are treated by the Relight editor, we can go back to our scene. Back to our scene and let's see how to enable Relight and use it to create several images from one render. From the Rendering tab, find the Relight option, tick the checkbox, and that's it. If the option is grayed out, it means that you are still in interactive mode and should change to production instead. We now have a list of all the light groups in the scene that we can modify to create different lighting setups. First, we'll have a look at the Relight options. Every group has its own controls. The on-off switch, the solo button, lights intensity, and finally color. Right above the groups we have three buttons. The first button creates a snapshot of the current settings. Let's change a few settings and click on the button. We can create as many snapshots as we like, and double-click on them to load the Relight settings. The next button resets the controls to their default values. The last one toggles the visibility of the light groups all at once. One thing to note here is that you can save the image as an img.thea file, which can be reopened with the Relight information stored in it. In the next part, we will use the camera settings to make use of depth of field. It can be enabled from the camera tab by changing the F-number value to anything other than pinhole. The focal point can be set in two ways. The first one is by using autofocus, which uses the center of the image to set the focal point for the first object it hits. To have more control, this option needs to be turned off and use the set button instead. We'll just click on the Set button and click on the viewport to place the focal point. The last part of this video deals with scene settings and batch rendering. For every scene, a user can define custom Thea settings for the following tabs: Camera, Environment, Display, and Render settings. All these are possible in the Scene and Batch Settings tab. In this project, we created a few scenes and we need to create custom settings for each one. As a general rule, if for example every scene will be using the same render settings, there's no reason to save them for each scene. All scenes will use the current settings instead. Let's start with the first scene and we will do the same for the rest. For this scene, we want to have the Thea physical sky, and also change display settings to adjust the exposure. To save both the environment and the display settings, we only have to click on the dots and make them blue, which means that custom settings have been saved. We will also save the camera settings, since we will enable depth of field for one of the following scenes. We went through the rest of the scenes and created custom settings for each. Double-clicking on the scenes will also change the SketchUp view. Doing so, you will also notice the values changing from scene to scene. Now that we have everything ready, we can proceed with batch rendering. Click Next to each scene in order to include them to batch rendering, and finally click on the Start button. You will be asked to set the output folder and a name for the images. The name of the scene will be added to the end of the given name. This brings us to the end of this course. Thank you for watching.